What makes semiconductor materials unique? Simply, semiconductor materials will not pass current as easily as conductors, nor block current as effectively as insulators. To better understand this relationship, let's briefly review conductors and insulators by comparing a general form for a single insulator atom and conductor atom. Copper is a conductor. As in all atoms, the electrons circle the nucleus in a number of orbiting bands. The outer band is called the valence band. Electrons in this band are more loosely bound to the nucleus than those in the inner bands. As a result, the valence electrons can be dislodged from their orbit. They are then potential current carriers and are called free electrons. Substances containing atoms with one or two valence electrons are considered conductors because the valence electrons can be freed easily. Copper has only one valence electron, and it is an excellent conductor. By comparison, poor conductors or insulators, such as glass, have many more valence electrons than conductors, most commonly 7 or 8. 8 electrons is the maximum any valence band can support. An atom with 8 valence electrons is considered stable since it will neither give up nor accept electrons easily. The valence electrons in an insulator's atom are very tightly bound to the nucleus. Consequently, very few free electrons can be dislodged, limiting any possible current flow.